My gurus have given me three methodology to revive this whole ecosystem of Kailasa on planet Earth. Three methodology to revive this conscious possibility science, living enlightenment science. One, Varnashrama Dharma, Sovereign Order of Kailasa. The Brahmana, Vaishya, Kshatriya, Shudra, Varnas, and Ashrama, Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasa. And there are subdivisions in this. Rudraganya, Sadvi, or Brahmacharini, Brahmachari. All that subdivisions put together. I call it Varnashrama Dharma. All the 108 orders, sovereign orders of Kailasa, is Varnashrama Dharma. That's a one methodology to revive this Kailasa ecosystem. Second, Gurukul, where a group of seekers, balasans, sannyasis sit with Guru and start manifesting powers, powerful cognitions, conscious possibilities. Through that, from all over the world, all the yoga prashtas are attracted. All the yoga prashtas are attracted towards me. Yoga prashta means, in the past many births you struggled, worked for enlightenment. But just before getting enlightened, last 2-3 patterns, you before breaking last few patterns, you left the body, you died. So this time you take birth in very rich families. Or the families where your parents and your ecosystem will allow you to go and be with the master. Bhagavad Gita very clearly explains the science of Yoga Prashta. How Yoga Prashta takes birth. If he has not broken the pattern for some luxury, desire, he takes birth in a rich family and exhausts that desire and breaks that pattern, completes it and reaches the guru's feet. Or he takes birth in a family ecosystem where the parents and everyone is supportive of you being with the master. If your pattern is just some unconscious, you take birth in a family ecosystem situation where you are supported to be with the master and come back to master. Work on your conscious possibilities and get enlightened. Understand? Gurukul is the lotus flower, attracts the bees, honey bees automatically. When a lotus blooms, honey bees automatically are attracted. When a Gurukul blossoms, the Gurukul ecosystem blossoms, from all over the world, all the yoga prashtas are automatically attracted. That's a second methodology. Third is creating a powerful energy field, Kailasa system, where the gods and goddesses of Kailasa, different dimensions and aspects of Paramashiva, directly embody, incarnate, and start manifesting this conscious possibility science to the world, like Skandamata. See, I created an ambience, ecosystem, put my tapas, and made Skandamata, Parashakti, who gave birth to Subramanya, that energy, source energy, assume embody itself as Skandamata Papa. Now, providing the atmosphere, ecosystem for her to blossom, manifest all her multi-dimensions. Nobody taught her. Ganesha is her brother, all that. I've installed a Ganesha in my courtyard in Bidhi, Adi Kailash, to take care of Skandamata. I requested, pray to that Ganesha. I prayed to that Ganesha, please take care of Papa. She automatically goes to that Ganesha and calls that Ganesha as Anna, plays with that Ganesha, even feeds that Ganesha. The ecosystem, energy field, Shakti Mandala is created where the incarnations, the gods and goddesses of Kailasa embody themselves and manifest the multi-dimensions and aspects of consciousness.